nights in a row of Prairie Grove Tiger basketball. Tonight, the Lady Tigers and our boys team Tigers will all be hosting the Rogers Mounties. Rogers 7A school. They come down to Prairie Grove to face the Tigers. It's good. With me tonight is going to be Randall Purcell. He's subbing for my normal partner, who's Derek Dugan. And Randall, good to have you with us. Thanks for stepping in tonight. Appreciate it. Last night, you know, we played Greenland here, and Greenland is defending champs of the 3A.
Back-to-back
3A champs, and came here last night and gave Prairie Grove all we wanted. We're a semifinalist from last year, and, you know, it was only a three-point victory.
Three-point victory, but a victory early in the year for Coach Froud's team is always important. He'll play the big teams and the good teams just to get him ready for conference. Good win, though, for him.
Absolutely. We're going to have a moment of silence, and then we'll follow with the national anthem.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
Randall, here's the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for the visiting Lady Mounties, number three, that is Kelsey Richmond. Number five, Emma Wisdom. Number 12, Elise Randles. Number 25, Madison Sandor. And number 43, Samantha Browns. That is the starting lineups for the Lady Mounties.
Now for your hometown, Lady
Tigers. And for our Prairie Grove Lady Tigers, here we go. Number three, Parker Lopez. She is a junior. Number 20, 5'3", junior Cambry Bartholomew. Number 21, a 5'5", senior Taylor Harton. Number 23, her sister, 5'6", senior, Maddie Harton. And number 33, a 5'7", senior, Ashley Cox. Of course, the Lady Tigers are coached by Kevin Froud. I think this might be his 11th season, 10th or 11th season now. He's assisted by Shelley Dugan.
I'll tell you one thing that I'm going to look for, Lynn, early. If you've noticed the last two games, Ashley Cox has got two fouls before she's barely got her warm-up top off, and so she's going to have to get away from that.
Yeah, she's really, you know, last night she got in a little foul trouble early, but the thing about that we saw from her, she came in the second half and got a lot of playing time. And
When she's on the floor, you know she's going to do a lot of positive things. So they really need – she's really the only size they have, so to speak. So she's important. She's going to have to learn to play without fouling.
Well, you know, the thing is that we do have, you know, we do have some bench to help out. I mean, we've got
– does have some depth,
you
know, this year.
Sarah James Stone, who is a 5'9 sophomore, played as a freshman, really steps in often. Here comes the tip and the jump. It's going to go. And look at Parker Lopez. Gets in there and takes that. Drives. Well, they're going to call her for a walk. I think she was hoping the contact should get the foul.
There was a lot of contact there.
And now bringing the ball down is number five for the Mounties, Emma Wisdom. And Wisdom gets it to Randles. Randles drives. Shot on the way. No good. Rebound's going to go to Lopez. I thought it was going to go to Lopez. Kind of battle back and forth. And Samantha Brown loses out of bounds for Rogers, and so the Lady Tigers going to have it.
Lynn, I believe Randles is kind of their big scorer. She dropped, I think, 17 last night in a tough loss to Huntsville girls.
Did they play Huntsville on the road?
They did. No, it was at Rogers.
At Rogers. Okay, and now Lady Tigers, the second night in a row. Both teams have played two nights in a row, so fatigue will be with both of them. Three-pointer! No good. Rebound goes. Going to go out of bounds. And now the Lady Mounties will have it. Just underway here, 7-17 to go here in the first quarter. Wow.
I think maybe the young Lady Tigers are still trying to get used to these new rims, huh, Lynn? They shot a pretty poor percentage in the first half, but they found the range in the second half.
Well, not only that, in the – wow, she's going to call for foul there. And it's going to be the first foul, comes at 7:05. Here is – ball gets in to Richmond, and she's picked up by Harton. And another foul. It looks like going to have on the floor. So the Harton twins each have a foul.
Had some foul trouble last night as well.
No, you know, I wonder if the rims are tight, too.
They seem to be very tight.
Here's a long three-pointer on the way. No good. Nice rebound that time by Rogers. And, boy, they missed the kind of a second shot opportunity. And here comes Taylor Harton. Brings it down to Lopez. Long three-pointer. No good. Bartholomew. And now coming down the court for the Mounties.
Randles.
Randles again. Nice little take that time by number three.
Good help. Good help defense.
Nice job by Cox. And now here comes Parker Lopez. This time they're going to call that on the floor. They're going to give her a shot on it.
I think they're going to give her two shots, Lynn. Good aggressive take, though. You like to see that.
They're going to let her get two shots. I thought they might call that on the floor, but we get a break there. Lopez Well, as Lopez comes to the line to shoot a couple. And the first basket of the game is a free throw. It's 1-0. Last night was the first games in the gym, and all three, both the junior high girls, junior high boy Lopez, the second shot, it's also good. Every game, Prairie Grove's first basket was a three-pointer.
Really?
So that was a nice
keen,
observation by
that is
Mr.
A keen,
Dugan.
A keen eye by you guys. Nothing gets by
I got to give that one to Dugan. He was all over that. Nice pass. Gets on the backside and a nice basket that time by Samantha Brown. Lady Tigers pushing the action quickly. Nice job and another foul on this one's going to be on Brown. This will be her first. Madison Sander got the other foul. So two team fouls for each team at this point.
You know, when you're smaller, which we're going to be most every night, you got to take it strong at them. I'm sure y'all pointed this out last night, Lynn, but I think Taylor Doss was the key to that game. You know, when they were struggling in the first half, she hit two or three three-pointers, kept them in the game.
This time we're going to get one of two. One of our East Lab students, Nacho Henry, he was just telling me that tonight the JV girls started their game off with a free throw. it's kind of following suit around here. Nice job defense this time by the Lady Tigers. And – nice job by Sarah James Stone. Good defense and a nice box out. And Doss comes in. There's Maddie Harton for three. No good. Rebound's going to go to number 25, Madison Sander.
So many weapons on this team, Lynn.
There is. I mean, and you know, even off the bench, you know, when Taylor Doss comes in and as does Stone – and both of them contribute
sure.
on both ends of
Absolutely.
The floor.
They're going to have nights that, you know, one or two of them can't knock down a three,
yeah,
then you got other options.
I'll tell you something after we our possession this time. Here comes Taylor Doss. She's going to get her for a walk. I got to tell you, there's a ref over there I have never seen before here. Now, I've,
well, you know what, Lynn? I'm going to say that's a bonus.
And I'm not so sure that two of the three tonight, I don't think I've ever seen them before.
No, I've seen Eugene was here last night, and then this one on the baseline's been here. But you're right, the one on the far end.
Well, No. Two of the three I haven't seen, and I remember them pretty well.
Not that we're criticizing them, because their mothers might be listening right now, Lynn. So, you know, they do the best they can.
Well, here we go. Is Lady Tigers up 3-2, 4:40 to go here in the first quarter. Kind of slow scoring start.
Kind of a sluggish. Can't get anything to fall. But, you know, when you're not knocking them down, go strong to the hole like that.
Ooh. And that one's blocked. And that nice block. And Emma Wisdom comes up with it. And now a jump ball that's going to go in favor of the Rogers Lady Mounties. Well, they're moving. They got good ball movement.
They do.
I say that, and then she holds it. Nice take, and a foul. I think it's going to be on Doss. And now Bartholomew and Cox are going to come right back in. So three team fouls for Prairie Grove. Doss with one, and the Harton twins each with one. And this shot is good.
Back out to Prairie Grove, number 33, and Ashley Cox, number 20, in the volume. And for Roger, number 14, Michael Williams.
I'm sure y'all alluded to it last night, but how awesome is this gym, man?
Oh, it's fantastic.
It's about as nice as the old gym, right?
Second one on the way.
Great facility, though. Outstanding.
Yeah, it is. So that was that. That was Wisdom, and she made one of two.
Somebody needs to knock down a three and take the lid off the goal for us.
Three-pointer. That bottom! Goes. There you go. You called for it, Mr. Purcell.
Ordered
and she delivered. 6-3.
Again, all these girls can shoot, so they're not all going to have off nights, I don't believe. Steal.
And now stolen by Bartholomew. Drive on the way.
Nice.
A foul.
Now on Rogers, number five, Emma Wisdom. Bartholomew at the line, shooting two.
Bartholomew misses the first free throw, and the second one's on the way, and it's missed. So right now from the free throw line, we're 3 of 6, I believe, already. That's about what we shot last night, Randall. We did not shoot real good free throws. That was close to 5-second call.
Good D.
Three-pointer on the way, no good. Nice box out that time by Maddie Harton. Here she comes down the floor. 3:05 to go here in the first quarter. Wow, nice
take.
No good. Rebound goes to Randall's. Now Randall's coming down quickly. She gives it up to Richmond. Richmond turns, shot, no good.
That's just good help defense by Ashley Cox.
Lady Tigers are playing really good defense, just not able to get that offense cranked up yet. Nice take down the baseline, and they're going to call for a walk.
I I don't recall last night if he went with Cox and Stone on the court
yes,
at the
he
same
did.
Time.
There was, there was a point last a night look. When Crown for Greenland was really giving us a hard time, and he brought them both in, and it slowed her down a bit.
Right. Well, you know, the Stone, she can step out and hit that three.
There's a three-pointer on the way from Randles. No good. Rebound goes after tip by Bartholomew to Stone and back to Bartholomew. Oh, she was looking up the floor. And Doss goes baseline, drive, shot. No good. Rebound goes to the Lady Mounties. And quickly they get it to Randles. Randles goes baseline. No good, but the foul is going to be on Maddie Hart, and that's going to be her second. So she's probably going to sit for a while. First one's on the way, and it's good. She makes them both. It's 6-5. Lady Tigers clinging to the lead. Now got good it in look. There. Nice job. And a good pass, good execution, and a nice basket made by Ashley Cox. 8-5, back to a three-point lead in a minute. Coming close to a minute and a half to go here in the first quarter.
Kind of caught him sleeping coming down the court. That's a good find by Camry.
Really was. Bartholomew, she's wanted it. Long three. No good. Rebound. A little bit of a push that time, but Lady Tigers don't come up with a rebound.
Shoot till you get hot, right, Coach?
Three-pointer on the way. That's number 20 for them. That's Maddie McKinney. And now Doss, she's going baseline, pulls back out. Looked like she's going to take that baseline there for a second. And here she comes, going to the middle. Nice take. And a good block by Randles. Oh, whoa.
Could have went either way.
I guess he's a little closer than I am to it. But
he didn't know any more than you do, though, Lynn.
I know that. But anyway, 38.5 seconds, 8-5, Lady Tigers lead.
Kind of feels like a boxing match, doesn't it, Lynn? Somebody's going to break out, knock down a couple of threes in a minute.
I don't know if it's early season shooting, the new gym, the rims, but
I would say yes.
Free throws. Walk.
She might have walked.
Holy smoke.
Got the Euro step.
That's a Euro step to the luggage claim. She's traveling.
We're playing NBA rules tonight, Lynn. You get 3.5.
And now here comes Harton. Going to have to get a shot off and fouled with 0.1 second.
Coach cannot be happy about that foul.
So Taylor Harden, first one on the way, and it's no good. So
those
now three of seven. Second one on the way by Harton, and this one is good. You got to string music on this thing to be able to get it.
Yeah, you better be pure.
Well, that's going to do it. After one quarter play, the Lady Tigers lead 9-5. Back after this.
Zing. Is it the work of a rocket scientist from NASA? Is it artificial intelligence from a distant planet? Zing is the new internet broadband service from PG Telco with speeds up to 50 megabits per second, no data caps, and an online security feature that makes daily digital activity safe and reliable. Your internet used to be high speed. Now it's more like intergalactic. Zing delivers the experience of digital connections in remarkable ways, and it's ready to help you in takeoff. All you got to do is call PG Telco 846-7200. That's 846-7200.
The sky's the limit with My Blue Checking from Arvest Bank. With My Blue, you'll sleep better at night knowing your checking account helps safeguard you and your family against identity theft, covering all types of identity fraud events,
okay,
financial or otherwise.
Get ready to start the second quarter. Possession arrow in favor of the Lady Tigers.
I don't know what percentage either team shot, Lynn, but it was not strong that first quarter.
Well, I'm looking down to my left here, and I see a lot of the class of 2015 sitting down there.
It's good support. Last night, same way. I looked at the starting lineup from the boys' team from last year was all here.
Yeah, well, I think, you know, a lot of them got a Thanksgiving break. And
want to check out the new digs, yep. You know.
There, turnaround jumper, no good by Bartholomew. Rebound goes to Mikhail Williams.
She's playing with two, Lynn, so somebody ought to go at her pretty hard.
Ooh, oh, wow.
Bailed her out by the new guy.
Lopez picks up her first foul. So the only one we have with two right now is Maddie Harton. And Coach Froud, you know, and the first one's made by Sander. How are they shooting from the line, Randall?
I believe they're now 3-for-5.
And make that three for six. So about 50% for them as well.
Good math.
I can do that kind of math. It's when you get to that sine and cosine and tangent stuff that I get a little bit.
See, I don't even know what you're talking about now.
There's a good take. And, oh, they're going to get her the foul. They're going to give her two shots. Mm. That was a nice little move there by Taylor to take it to the hole.
You know, pound for pound. She's not scared to take it at the big girls.
No. Taylor Harton, first one on the way, gets the roll this time.
I think
time.
That's the first roll I've seen.
10-6. Lady Tigers here is going to be the second on the way from Harton. A little string music on this one. Yes, sir.
Nice.
11-6.
You know, that's the thing about Prairie Grove girls. Like last year, you know, they can be kind of, well, they're not doing much, and all of a sudden anybody can hit two or three in a row.
Wow, and there, you know, the press that time, we had good press. They were able to get around it.
That's the thing about it, if you can break it, you're going to have numbers.
And it's 11-8. Oh, we got away with a walk there, too. We remind you, after this game, we'll have the boys' game. They'll be playing the Rogers as well. Long three. Bottom! Hey, there we go. 14-8.
Shoot till you get hot.
And a six-point lead. I believe this is the largest lead of the game for the Lady Tigers. Oh, boy, we got a good break there because number 14 for Lady Mounties had pretty good position. That's Williams. She was unable to bring it in. Long three again by Bartholomew. No good. Rebound goes to Maddie McKinney. And Maddie going to pull up. You know, here's the thing tonight, and I'll make a comment after this time.
Good help defense. Rebound.
No good. And nice job by Taylor Harden. You know,
good look.
There's a good – and now – she's going to get two shots. You were talking about Ashley Cox getting those quick fouls tonight. No fouls. No fouls right now for
Cox. And you know what? And, you know, she still plays aggressive. You just got to learn, you know, when to not be so aggressive and just be smart, move your feet, get good position. Usually you get those cheap fouls when you're not in position.
Well, 5:28 to go here in the first quarter. Lady Tigers up 14-8.
They seem like maybe a half step slow tonight. You know, they played that's a tough game. It's a tough back-to-back playing a team like Greenland. Emotional game.
Well, these guys played a game like – so both teams You know, that's what I'm saying. At least tonight, you know.
Thanks for blowing my theory out of the water there, man.
That's all they did.
They both had really hard games. Yeah. Rogers played Huntsville close. Huntsville ended up winning. You know, that's always a struggle.
Huntsville's always tough.
Yeah, they
basketball.
Are. I was talking to Coach Ed, and he said Coach Stafford said their boys' team is going to be probably his best shooting team he's ever had. It's a pretty big statement.
That is
through
a huge
the Trumbo
statement.
Years.
Well, I'm telling you, if that's true, their 2007 state championship team, that he had as good as shooters.
Trumbo and Pounce and those boys, they were good.
And then he had Dustin Todd. I mean, they were loaded that mm-hmm. year. And then
they had some battles with Farmington and even Prairie Grove somewhat.
Well, in 2007, they their only loss was to Prairie Grove in the and the famous Kevin Morton into the buzzer shot, and there's a free throw no good by Harton. 14-8 remains the score as Taylor takes her second one on the way. This one goes in.
She's making a home there at the free throw line tonight.
And how she's shooting right at 500 or a little over?
It's 5 of 9 right now.
5 of 9. And now Taylor Harton with the ball, looking and takes a little stutter step, seeing if she can get that baseline, not able to do it. Now, whoa, that was a dangerous pass.
Bailed her out there.
Lopez kicks it out. Bartholomew for three. Bottom! There we go. It's a 10-point lead now for the Lady Tigers.
That's an amazing shot she has, isn't it, Lynn? About the time you say, oh, what are you doing? It goes in. She spent many hours in the gym.
Long three by the Lady Mounties. I thought they were going to return the favor. They weren't able to do so. Nice pass.
That's about 5 seconds in the lane so far.
They're going to get that foul on Bartholomew, that's her first foul. So the nice thing about the Lady Tigers tonight, they're spreading the fouls out pretty well.
That is true.
We've got 6 fouls, one on Lopez, one on Taylor Harton, one on Bartholomew, one on Doss, and there's 2 on Maddie Harton. 3-pointer on the way, no good. And another rebound, another second chance opportunity. And now Bartholomew picks up another quick foul. It's 2.
Cheap one. Lynn, I can already tell you. Coach Froud coming out of his shell a little bit. He's worth the $5 bill to come watch Coach.
He's definitely worth the price of admission. Especially my price of admission.
Wait a minute. I need to go get my $5 back there.
Shot on the way. Good. From the free throw line, that is Maddie McKinney. 18-9. Whoa, somebody just took a spill.
Makes them both.
Hey, hold on just a second.
As we was doing some housekeeping there, great look inside Ashley Cox for two.
Well, no,
Coach for Rogers calls a quick timeout.
Trying to take care of all these little kids around here. That
you're always looking out for everyone, Lynn. Such a special man.
No, she took a spill, and the girl didn't.
If it's not little girls here, it's some waitresses in Central Arkansas. I'm sure he'll relay that story at some point this season.
No. That was your deal. 407, 20-10. Lady Tigers up. Picking them up full court this time.
That's good D.
They just threw it away. It is good D. Under 4 minutes.
Taylor Doss moves her feet so well. And that's how you play defense with your feet.
Yep. She did a nice job of not getting the foul. You know, it's got, it's really kind of probably strange. Oh, wow. You know, for, we were talking about some alumni being here tonight. It's probably strange to come to this new gym because everything you ever knew was in the old gym.
Exactly. All these former students here are like, why couldn't they have done it the year I was here?
Oh. Bottom by Parker Lopez. You're right. They're all saying, good, we just got this just a tad earlier, but
right,
it's,
right.
It's such a nice, wonderful, wonderful facility.
This team is so dangerous, Lynn. They can just, it just feels like they're not doing anything, and then bam, bam, stretch the lead out to 13. Good. I like they're letting them play a little bit down low.
I don't know if you have it notated there, but I would say a lot of our points have come from 3-point.
I think we've hit, what, three?
Well, Doss hit one.
Camry
Bartholomew hit two. And now they're just taking their time. Boy, there's a little slip there. Nice job, Sarah James. And they're going to get her for a foul. Randall's, I don't think she liked that call. .229 to go. First shot on the way. No good from Sarah James Stone. 23-10. Second one on the way. This one's good. 24-10.
I don't know if I think you might have cut me off a little earlier, Lynn, but if a team ever shoots over 50% in this gym, they're going to score 80 points. You better be able to have some soft touch.
Nice take that time and able to convert. That was a good job that time by Sander. She's been aggressive tonight, you know, going to the basket. Here comes Lopez. In and out and back
good.
Up by Cox.
Ooh.
Wow, no call.
A little bit of contact.
Wow. Here comes Randall's. She has to pull it out. Long three on the way. And it's good. Well. Nice shot. Maddie McKinney. 24-13. Yep. Lady Tigers' largest lead has been 14.
You just got to not hit the rim and you'll be all right.
Here's Doss. Three. Short. And no call. Now they're going to give the call, and they're going to have a chance for 1-1.
Calls like that, you just don't have to make. Didn't hurt the possession. Oh.
Probably not come out.
It's a quick way to get back in the game, shooting free throws, Lynn.
Yep. Second shot.
Made them both.
Made them both. Sander makes them both. It's 24-15. Three-pointer, no good. And I'll tell you, we had a 14-point lead. It's down to 9, and we've lost that lead. Boy, lucky we didn't get a foul call there.
Those rims got to be frustrating a lot of people.
Wow, we got a break.
That could have went either way.
24-15. No, we had the 14-point lead with about a minute and 30, minute and 40, and they scored 5 quick points. With the three-pointer and the foul. And now it's 24-15, just under a minute to go, 59.7 seconds. Lopez, no good. Rebound by Cox.
Nice.
And Ashley puts it up and in. 26-15.
6 points, first half for Ashley Cox.
There we go. Lady Tigers going to get it. Coach Frell helping him out, the ref that time.
He's always there to help out.
I think he was making sure they didn't call it off of Ashley because she was down there with, I think it was Ashley. Maybe, yeah, I don't know. It's one of them down there was battling.
Well, those refs need to know if they need some help, Frell to help them out. That's 6 big points for Ashley Cox. You know, any point she gets is really kind of a bonus.
The big number I like up there is a 0 next to that foul number.
Correct. I think we talked about that in the opening, right?
Yeah, you did. You talked about it was important that she not pick those up. And for 2 nights running, she got she got 2 fouls.
Literally before she had a sweat going. 3 on number 25.
So Sandor now with 3 fouls. And it's 12.9 seconds. Harton makes the first one, 27-15.
You know, this even though Rogers is probably not going to, you know, finish in the top 3 or so, and they're still 7-8 team.
And now misses the second one, 27-15, under 10 seconds to go, down to 7-6.
Hand up. Good help. Good.
And it goes in.
It's good help, Dave.
So
it's a good
nice,
shot.
Nice dot job. Good execution down the end that time by Randall. So after one half of play, the Lady Tigers lead 27-17. We're going to take a break, and then just before we start the second half, we'll go through the stats.
You're listening to a broadcast of the Prairie Grove Tigers at pgtigersonline.com.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to the skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority, and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to these skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to these skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association supports good sportsmanship. All spectators have a responsibility while watching an athletic contest because their actions influence high school youth. It is important that they display the best of sportsmanship to help instill proper attitudes and ideals in these youth.
The Arkansas Activities Association recognizes that an athlete represents more than themselves in athletic competition. They represent their team, their fellow students, their teachers, and their community. Athletes who display good sportsmanship reflect high moral standards.
The Arkansas Activities Association recognizes that athletes represent more than themselves in athletic competition. They represent their team, their fellow students, their teachers, and the community. Athletes who display good sportsmanship reflect high moral standards. The Arkansas Activities Association recognizes that athletes represent more than themselves in athletic competition. They represent their team, their fellow students, their teachers, and the community. Athletes who display good sportsmanship reflect high moral standards.
Love God, love others, serve others. The simple motto of Prairie Grove Christian Church. Whether supporting missionaries in Japan, in Africa, doing mission work in Cambodia and Haiti, or building homes in Texas, or fun for the entire family with Upward basketball and cheerleading, you'll find our members seeking to show love for God through love for our neighbors. If you are looking for a church home, we invite you to experience PGCC firsthand. We have convenient service times on Sundays at 9 and 10:30 a.m., and we have exciting ministries for your children and teens. Prairie Grove Christian Church, serving Western Washington County and beyond. Love God, love others, serve others. Prairie Grove Christian Church.
PG Telco is the proud sponsor of PGTigersOnline.com, where you can find out all the very latest of what's going on with all the sports teams right here in Prairie Grove. But PG Telco is more, a lot more. They offer phone, internet, long-distance services, and bundles, making it all affordable. And that includes DirecTV. For your home or office, staying connected to the fast-paced world is as easy as calling PG Telco. Call 846-7200. That's 846-7200. PG Telco, built on community, focused on progress. Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsors of Prairie Grove High School Athletics and also proud of their huge inventory, both new or used. You'll find what you're looking for at Everett Chevrolet. Are you looking for the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road? You're looking for the Chevy Silverado, and they've got them. How about the Chevy Camaro? How about the Chevy Corvette? It's all waiting for you at Everett Chevrolet. Family-owned and customer-friendly. Everett Chevrolet, I-49 at Elm Springs Road. Everett Chevrolet says, go Tigers! Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsor of Prairie Grove Athletics, is also home to the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road, the Chevy Silverado. And at Everett, they don't just have one or two. They have over 100 on the lot, every option, every color, so go pick yours out today. And at Everett Chevrolet, they're backed by a super service and parts department, champions in their own right. Everett Chevrolet, family-owned, customer-friendly, I-49 at Elm Springs Road. Everett Chevrolet says, go Tigers! For over 100 years, the Lugan Buell name has served the area of Prairie Grove with honor and integrity in a family's most dire time. Four generations of excellence in service. All aspects of caring for your loved one are handled with tender care, as well as with the honor and dignity they deserve. The type of service, the monument, every single aspect is handled with that special Lugan Buell care, including the opportunity to work with them on pre-planning. If you have any questions, please call 846-2141. That's 846-2141. Lloyd Wayne Lugan Buell. Stacy Lugan Buell, J.C. Dobbs stand ready to continue that Lugan Buell tradition. For more information, they invite you to visit their website, LuganBuell.com.
The sky's the limit with My Blue Checking from Arvest Bank. With My Blue, you'll sleep better at night knowing your checking account helps safeguard you and your family against identity theft. Covering all types of identity fraud events, financial or otherwise, anywhere in the world. You'll be able to deposit a check to My Blue just by using your smartphone, and you'll have the freedom of more branches and more hours. Have higher expectations about banking? Make the switch to My Blue Checking, only from Arvest Bank.
Zing. Is it the work of a rocket scientist from NASA? Is it artificial intelligence from a distant planet? Zing is the new internet broadband service from PG Telco with speeds up to 50 megabits per second. No data caps and an online security feature that makes daily digital activity safe and reliable. Your internet used to be high speed. Now it's more like intergalactic. Zing delivers the experience of digital connections in remarkable ways, and it's ready to help you in takeoff. All you got to do is call PG Telco, 846-7200. That's 846-7200.
You're listening to a broadcast of the Prairie Grove Tigers at PGTigersOnline.com.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to the skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority, and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to these skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority, and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association believes that athletes are taught many things through sports. In addition to these skills, they learn self-control, ideals of fair play and honesty, respect for authority and for opposing players. To learn these values results in maximum benefits from his or her athletic experiences.
The Arkansas Activities Association supports good sportsmanship. All spectators have a responsibility while watching an athletic contest because their actions influence high school youth. It is important that they display the best of sportsmanship to help instill proper attitudes and ideals in these youth.
The Arkansas Activities Association recognizes that an athlete represents more than themselves in athletic competition. They represent their team, their fellow students, their teachers, and their community. Athletes who display good sportsmanship reflect high moral standards.
The Arkansas Activities Association recognizes that athletes represent more than themselves in athletic competition. They represent their team, their fellow students, their teachers, and the community. Athletes who display good sportsmanship reflect high moral standards.
Lynn Gregson is former. He shows up at the last second, but he's ready to roll.
Here we go as we get ready to start the second half. Rogers will get the ball to start.
Throw some quick stats at you, Lynn. Parker Lopez, Camry Bartholomew, and Ashley Cox lead the way with 6 points apiece.
Well, it's good to have the spread out of the
it is
points.
Taylor had five. Taylor Harton. Quick sub there. Coach wasn't happy with her. Three-pointer from number 20 is off. Rebound by Taylor Harton. Going to set up the offense. Work the ball around. Always looking for that best shot. Call little quick steps there on Camry. See if some refs call that, some don't. Some will let you get away with it. We've got an injury on the court, but I think the paramedics are looking into that. That would be my co-worker here, Lynn Gregson. A lot of good help defense. For those of you wondering, Lynn is still in the house.
And, you know, that time Richmond just kind of came in. I thought she was going to get a foul. She didn't get it, and now
she kind of anticipated that, yeah.
And Bartholomew brings it over. No score yet. This is the same place we were when we started the second half. Maddie Harton back in the game. She sat for a long time with those two fouls. Lopez gets it to Maddie. Maddie thought about it. She gives it back to Lopez. Lopez. Prairie Grove being patient, looking for a good shot here. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound into the hands of Brown, and they quickly get it up the floor. There's Richmond again. She gives it back. Browns has it. Randles is not in the game right now.
She just got pulled just a second ago.
And Bartholomew, nice opportunity that time by Brown. Didn't quite convert. It's 6 minutes to go still. 2 minutes have gone by. No score yet here in the third period. And they're going to get her for a walk. That's happened to her twice tonight.
It has. You know, Rogers plays pretty good. They're pretty long. They move their feet well. They're pretty well coached.
I'm looking across the way here, and I see a former Prairie Grove great, both baseball and basketball, Logan Areola. I haven't seen Logan in quite some time.
The new digs just draw them all out, doesn't it, Lynn?
Oh, absolutely. Here is a rebound by Bartholomew. Well, she almost put up her foot as
almost
well.
Almost drug that foot. Again, look at Rogers. They're long. There's some tall girls.
And there's a little jumper. No good. And Brown comes down with a rebound.
Maddie needed to get it going kind of like she did in the second half last night.
Nice feed inside, and they're going to get Taylor Harton with the foul. 5:10 to go. Still no field goal yet.
No points at all, Lynn.
Yeah, still no points. I thought I was about to say here's the first one, but they haven't got it yet.
Never doubt me, Lynn.
27-17. We are 3 minutes into this third quarter. Brown with her second shot on the way. Lady Tigers have led by as many as 14, lead by 10 right now as Brown takes a second one, and that one goes in. First points of the second half is a free throw. It's 27-18. And a nice job. Get out of the lane. There's a three-pointer by Lopez. No good. Rebound goes to Brown. And so Lady Tigers, a little cold to start this third period. Really, so is Rogers. They got a free throw. So
again, you know, it was a tough game last night. Maybe they're a little heavy-legged.
Down to how you doing, man? Good to see you.
Let's just enjoy this conversation from Lynn and a spectator.
Yeah, no, I want to make sure you got me off, right?
No. Baseline drive by Parker Lopez. Can't get the roll. It's like a lidge on the basket. A little bailout by the ref. Second on Taylor Doss. Coach Froud's going to have to talk about a timeout with 3:52 left in the third period. Prairie Grove holding a 9-point lead, 27-18.
I tell you, sorry about that. With all these alumni coming in, I hadn't seen Logan. I'll tell you, the team that he played on was 2007-2008 was his senior year. That was the year after Islet and Scroggins were here, and you know that was a great team. And they didn't expect much from that following year, and yet they matched the same record that Scroggins did the very next year, won the district again and went to the state tournament again, back-to-back years. Just an incredible bunch of young guys.
Good run.
And had Kevin Morton, they had Logan Areola, Heath Brockmeyer, had my son Ty, and then also Tanner Goldman with a starting five that year.
Delton Rose, he was after that, correct?
He was a little bit after that. Yep, here comes the first free throw in the way, and it's good. So the only points after – we're halfway through this quarter, Randall, and
Parker had a good drive baseline. She just couldn't get it to finish, couldn't get it to fall.
Well, Wisdom makes both, and that 14-point lead has been cut in half down to 7.
We're going to have to get busy.
You know, his first word was out of his mouth to me, this is beautiful, talking about this gym. And
It's not hard to notice that.
And you said it. All the alumni want to say, gosh, why didn't they have this when we were playing? Three-pointer on the way. No, wow, off the mark that time.
They just look a little off tonight, Lynn. Good steal. Maybe that's what they need to do. Turn up the pressure, get some easy baskets.
And now Doss with the ball. We need some kind of offense, and now we're going to get a foul. That's the
ticky-tack.
That's the first foul of the quarter, or the half, I should say, for the Lady Mounties. That's Maddie McKinney. It's her first foul, team's first. 3:24 to go. Still no score in this.
We've yet
third
to
quarter.
Break the ice.
We've had some decent lemon. We throw that one away. Oh, someone tipped it. Oh, we got a break that time.
I tell you, you know what, Lynn, as good as the gym looks inside, spectacular view outside at
night.
Oh,
yeah, yeah, yep.
Did it well.
Especially the way the lights and the, you know, the home of the Tigers, everything just really looks nice.
Outstanding.
Gets it into Bartholomew. 3:15 to go here in the third quarter.
You know, we come out hot in the third period last night. Just kind of a little different view tonight.
Nice take. No good. And now they're going to get Sarah James Stone with that foul.
Oh, they did. They did call a foul, didn't they?
It's her second foul, team third. And the Lady Mounties can cut this thing to five, possibly even four. Smart play that time by Maddie McKinney. She knocked it off, I think, Lopez over there.
She hurt her side a little bit. Coach is going to get her out.
Harton's going to come in for Lopez. So on the floor right now, Bartholomew, Doss, Stone, Harton, and Harton.
D. Try to back cut there. They read it well.
Three-pointer on the way. No good. And Doss comes down with a rebound.
Didn't matter what the rims were like on that shot.
Richmond shot that one. And now Maddie Harton for three short. But the ball's back. Boy, we got a break there to get the ball back. 2:36. Lady Tigers up 27-20. Want to recognize our ESLAB students, Chris Morey, Christian Dowdy, Alex, the Nacho Man Henry, and Miles Eubanks, our IT guy, our ESLAB instructor, Heath Whitley. Really appreciate them tonight.
That's an attractive bunch over there as well, Lynn. Skill and looks.
Definitely on a skill level. Bartholomew for three.
Get in there.
No good. Rebound goes to Sander.
Good help. Don't reach. Those hands straight up.
I got Mr. Miyagi over here getting me feeling better real quick.
Whoa. I need to get a room. Goodness. See what you miss out when you don't come to the arena? Never know what you might see.
And free throw is made. I don't think there's been a basket. Has it all been free throws?
All free throws.
Man. All free throws. And we are 6 minutes into the third quarter. It was 27-17, and they've made now five free throws, and they've cut what was at one time a 14-point lead down to five. Lady Tigers need a basket
big time. Yep. Need to break the ice. Lynn, you ever seen a quarter where there was no baskets made?
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. It's been a while, but, yeah, we've seen them.
Oh, you saw me play in high school. I see.
There's Harton. Drive. No good. Rebound's going to go.
She's got to go up stronger.
Again.
It's a good take. She doesn't go up strong.
Sander gets another rebound, and the Lady Mounties trying to close the gap even more.
Good D. Good
nice
D.
job that time.
D.
Excellent defense.
Sarah Jane working hard down low. But, you know, if you're not going to score, you better play some lockdown D.
We're down to 1 minute to go here in the quarter. Lady Tigers still looking for their first points of the quarter.
Good Tay.
And knock now – Bartholomew for three.
There you go.
In and out. No good. Doss hustles. Unable to control it. 53.
We just came by a basket this quarter. Goodness.
We've just been off. I mean, that was a good look. It actually rimmed in and
out. It was a good look. Good ball movement. They got the shot they wanted. Just could knock it down.
It's funny. I know this is only our second night in the gym, but I'm starting to notice where people sit. People are identifying. They're nesting. Good take inside. Oh. No good that time. Really a good play that time by Richmond from the Mounties. Unable to convert. No, I'm starting to watch people. They're finding their spots.
Are you saying they're marking their territory,
yeah,
Lynn?
It's kind of like church. You know, there's certain people just don't sit in a certain place.
Oh, I do. Oh, yeah. You got to have that same pew. Lynn, I look down to my left. Another pretty outstanding athlete from Prairie Grove, Ty Tice.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And Ty playing baseball down at Central Arkansas. There's a good
Nice.
And an opportunity. The basket comes. It's actually the first field goal by either team. In the third quarter, comes with 7.2 seconds and a chance for an old-fashioned three by Hart.
That was a good strong take there. Good little runner.
Boy, we need to convert this, and she does.
Nice.
What's her free throw percentage now at this point? Or her?
It's like 8 out of 12, Lynn.
8 of 12. Another three-pointer. That's off. Wow. I said it was off. Hit that backboard. Almost went in. Well, it was 27-17.
5-3 in scoring.
5-3 in the third quarter. Let's take a break. We'll be back for the fourth and final quarter.
For over 100 years, the Luganbuehl name has served the area of Prairie Grove with honor and integrity in a family's most dire time. Four generations of excellence in service. All aspects of caring for your loved one are handled with tender care, as well as with the honor and dignity they deserve. The type of service, the monument, every single aspect is handled with that special Luganbuehl care, including the opportunity to work with them on pre-planning. If you have any questions, please call 846-2141. That's 846-2141. Lloyd Wayne Luganbuehl. Stacy Luganbuehl, J.C. Dobbs stand ready to continue that Luganbuehl tradition. For more information, they invite you to visit their website, luganbuehl.com. Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsor of Prairie Grove Athletics, is also home to the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road, the Chevy Silverado. And at Everett, they don't just have one or two. They have over 100 on the lot, every option, every color, so go pick yours out today. And at Everett Chevrolet, they're backed by a super service and parts department, champions in their own right. Everett Chevrolet, family-owned, customer-friendly, I-49 at Elm Springs Road. Everett Chevrolet says, go Tigers!
Okay, we're back for the fourth quarter. Lady Tigers with just one basket and a free throw.
It was a big one, though.
And it was. It stretches the lead back out to 8. And now can we heat up here for the fourth quarter?
They'll be fine. They keep working the ball, keep moving the ball. Some of these shots are going to fall.
Wow.
Or they're going to fall. Maybe they're thinking about that turkey and dressing already, Lynn.
Three-pointer short. And Lopez gets it out. Nice hustle that time by Parker.
Good look.
Nice job by Harton. Back up to a 10-point lead. Ashley Cox now with 8 points. And they've all been right there.
Good penetration. Drew the defense. Dished it off. It's a good move. What your point guard needs to do.
That was just an excellent, excellent execution that time. And it really set up by Taylor Harton. And now Maddie drives, and she's going to be fouled. She can go to the line.
Lynn, I saw when he took out the Randall's girl right at the first second, but I don't know. She hadn't been back in the game, though. I don't think she's hurt or anything, but maybe her feelings are just hurt.
I don't know, but she's not got foul trouble or anything, does she?
No, sir.
And Harton has really struggled tonight a little bit.
She's been a little off tonight.
And she, you know, that's what's really good. Prairie Grove has more than one person that's going to put it in.
Speak of Randall's, here she comes. I guess Coach heard me talking.
Better be careful what you say. 6:58 to go in the ball game. Lady Tigers up 33-22. Back to a double-digit lead. As Maddie Harton makes 1 of 2. That was her first point of the night.
It was. Good.
And now here's got 2-on-1.
Bounce pass.
Gives
good
up
pass.
And blocked that time by Randall's.
Just a little sluggish. But that's all right. You know, you're going to have nights like that. You keep fighting, keep working, play good defense, give yourself a chance to win.
A three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound goes to Parker Lopez.
Look up.
Lopez looks good. Down, and now nice.
Nice.
And there it is, double digits now.
Way to run the floor. Good things happen when you do that.
And the Lady Tigers scored 5 points already in this quarter whenever they were really struggling, scored in the third period.
Again, we talked, Lynn, you know, about when one or two is not hot, you got somebody else who can step up. Ashley Cox tonight with 10 huge points. I can assure, if Ashley knocks down 10 points every game, we're going to win a lot of games.
Well, at 35-22, she's the leading scorer right now in the game with 10 points.
There's another present PG guy over there. You see that guy? He don't know if he wants to play baseball, basketball, football. He don't know.
Whatever he decides to do, I'm sure he will be fantastic.
He will do it well. Yes, he will. I hope, actually, I'm looking forward to seeing him play basketball, but hopefully not for about three more weeks, right? We just veered right off into football, didn't we?
Well, that game does come up this Friday against Star City. We had full pressure there. And now Sander brings the cross, and the Lady Mounties trying to make one final run to see if they can get back in this thing.
Stretch us up to 15, we'll be in good shape.
Three-pointer, no good, and the rebound. Boy, there were three Lady Tigers had that thing boxed out.
I can assure you are not going to see one girl not blocking out.
And there is Bartholomew. Woo! Nice take. And nice, the largest lead of the game now, 37-22. And here's the thing. Even though Rodgers has made 5 points, they've not made a field goal. They've not made a basket from the floor. They got five free throws.
Did you see Cameron used her left hand on that play? Oh, she is left-handed, isn't she?
Randall's, you talked about her being their scorer last night. Oh, that one goes in.
She called that, did she?
Sander, that's their first basket of the second half. Comes almost 11 minutes of play with, Randall's doesn't have a point tonight. Oh, no, I'm sorry, she has four. I was looking at the foul there for a minute. She's got 4 points.
She didn't have any in the second half.
Here's Lopez and Bartholomew for three. No good. Rebound goes to Maddie Harton, and she doesn't get the foul. 37-25, 4:40 to go in the game. Gives it up to Randall's. Randall's back to Sander. She's picked up by Lopez. She bobbles it, and there's going to be a jump ball, and it's going to go to, you know, when you have a jump ball and a possession where they're going like that, that's like getting a possession back. Sure. They already had possession of the ball. And now they retain possession, but now the next time that arrow comes, it goes in our favor.
I remember back when they did actually have a jump ball, when they had a jump ball. I guess they figured that was too hard for referees to be able to, you know, toss the ball in the air.
You know what? I think the genesis of it, I'll wait till after we have transition play here.
I'm going to hear Waller on that a minute.
Here is the Lady Tigers up by 12. I was going to say, the genesis of that, I think, came when you got these real tall guys and real small guys doing jump balls. You know, because a lot of the small guards back in the day would tie up these centers, and there was no way they were going to get the jump ball. And I think that's what it – I think that was the genesis of it.
We'll go with that. Nice move.
If not, it actually sounded good, didn't it?
Ooh. Pretty athletic one there. It's a great move. Better defense, though. Just got to be smart. Be strong with the ball here on out, and we'll be all right.
Down, getting close, 3.5 minutes to go here in the ball game. Lady Tigers up 37-25 on Rodgers. Tipped, but
recognize that double team coming at her.
Lady Tigers just kind of running clock now, and spreading the floor. Coach Frow, at this time of the year, he's working on things.
Sure.
Right now, the girls are really preparing for February.
Absolutely.
You know, March.
Battle-tested.
And going to take it inside. She'll be found by Randall's. Could be Randall's first foul.
Foul on Rodgers, number 12, Elise Randall's. Timeout, Rodgers.
Who else you got in the crowd tonight, Lynn? Santa Claus here today?
I don't know.
Not yet.
But you're right. A lot of people come out to see the new facility.
It was a good crowd last night, wasn't it?
On December the 15th, we'll have the official grand opening of the gym that night. We'll be hosting Huntsville. It'll be the first conference game. And
are we going to have like a big wine bottle that we're going to smash up against the wall outside?
Wow. Derek, Randall, I just got, I think this is the new playoff
Oh, what, the top four tonight?
The top four.
Let me see if I can guess without you telling me. We got Alabama. We got Clemson. We've got Notre Dame. And I bet OU might have jumped right up there.
You got Clemson at number one, Alabama at number two, Oklahoma at number three, and Iowa at number four.
No Notre Dame.
Which means Notre Dame slipped out, and I'm really surprised by that.
You know what, though? If they still have Stanford. If they beat Stanford, I'm afraid that's going to put them up there in the top four.
Well, what surprises me about Oklahoma, really, I mean, is that Oklahoma was blessed that TCU didn't make a two-point conversion or try to play in overtime.
Right, with a third-string quarterback.
Yeah, I'm surprised they actually got that. But anyway, that's just one man's opinion. Mm-hmm. 3:02 to go. Here is Lopez. It's good. And when I look at it, I know we're watching basketball, we're talking football too, but when I look at a common opponent of Oklahoma and Notre Dame, you've got Texas, and we know what they did to Oklahoma, and Notre Dame blew them out of the stadium.
That might go down as one of the worst losses all year.
Cross-court pass, three-pointer on the way, no good.
Wow. Just kind of threw Ashley out of the way.
And Rogers going to retain the basketball. 2:49 to go in the game. Lady Tigers up by 14.
Pretty good moving screen there.
Oh, they're going to call a moving screen on Madison Sander. That's her. That's it for her. Yep. That's five fouls.
She's not sure about that, but definitely five. You're not going to play anymore.
I don't know if she knows she's fouled out yet.
Still think she's wondering why they called it on her. She moved a little bit. I mean, they could have let it gone, but she definitely moved.
And now Maddie Harton.
I don't know if teams are going to have a whole lot of luck pressing Prairie Grove this year.
Well, we got a lot of ball handlers.
A lot of ball handlers. They're smart. They're heady. Been there. Experience alone, they're going to do a lot well.
Yeah, they're really. That's the one thing was the experience of the Lady Tigers. And now you're just seeing there. He's just spread it out to a four corner. They're going to call her out of bounds. 2:16 to go. In the ball game. Lady Tigers up 39-25. Again, we appreciate our East Lab students, Chris Morey, Christian Dowdy, Nacho Henry, Miles Eubanks, and Heath Whitley all helping out tonight.
Coach Froud never misses an opportunity to do some coaching.
You know, I wonder if we get this thing down with a double-digit lead. I wonder if he'll put any of the, you know, just to have a chance to have some subs in. But it's been tough getting that stretch lead tonight.
It has. I mean, it's almost been like a grind, but, you know, they've stayed the course and they're going to get a win.
Two minutes and 13 seconds to go. And
wow,
another. Mm-hmm. They're going to call.
Rogers, number 43, Samantha Brown.
Samantha Brown has that foul, and that's.
New refs found him a call he likes.
Well, that's her third foul. And now.
Being the 1-1, the next foul.
Oh, wow, yep, she got the walk. That's a good call.
Too much dribbling there against that pressure. Don't reach. Love seeing that call from the referee at half court.
.155 to go, 39-25. Lady Tigers going to win their second consecutive game to move to, I believe, 2-1 on the year. 3-2.
3-1. Beat Farmington.
Three.
Lost to Northside.
Yep. Yeah, that's right. I should have remembered Farmington. And a nice job and a chance for an and one.
Boy, you saw her athleticism.
Randall's right there. She's smiling, too.
Number 3, Parker Lopez. Basket was good. Randall's at the line.
With a minute 45, Ashley Cox, no fouls tonight.
Wow.
10 points. Bartholomew got 11, and that's the only one that has more. 39-28. Next time that we have a basketball, well, the webcast obviously will be this week against for football with Star City coming to town against the Prairie Grove Tigers for quarterfinal. But the next time the girls play will be that we'll webcast will be December 1st against Farmington, this time in this gym. We played in their new gym just a week ago. Boy, she pushed off.
Yes, she did. Cleared out some space. She's woke up.
You know, this would be a chance. You know, Coach Froud will have an opportunity to do some coaching here. Because,
right.
Well, we struggled, you know, trying to close this thing out.
Right. Nice.
Wow.
Wow. Without fouling, too.
And now,
great block.
Lady Tigers will go to the line, and now with 58.7.
You know, they could have cut it to seven there,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, we were counting that victory before
it
happened.
Were.
But
yep.
Now looking like if they can stretch it out here. But seeing stranger things happen.
Lopez at the line, shooting one.
At the end of the game, we'll name our Everett Chevrolet player of the game. And Randall will go through the scoring and the stats.
Which may or may not be accurate.
We got a little help if you want to check it up there.
I'm not sure if that's accurate either, Lynn. I'm just saying.
Are you busting on Coach Elder not keeping that thing up?
Oh, is that well, everything's great.
The second shot made.
I thought Dougie Doug was down there doing that as well.
And it's back to an 11-point lead.
She's
good take.
Didn't she?
Boy, you know,
she woke up these last few minutes.
You know what? She had 4 points for most of the game, she's at 11 and a foul.
She's had seven in about the last minute and a half.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Taylor Doss now getting ready to score. Getting ready to score from the free throw line, let's hope.
Like that confidence.
No good on the one-and-one. Here she comes again. Good pull-up shot. Good. Nine. She has got 9 points literally in the last minute. Boy, where's she been?
Well, she was on the bench for the whole third quarter. We appreciate that from their unforced
turnovers. They've just cut it down to 7, Randall, with 27 seconds. That's 3
Taylor,
possessions.
Taylor tweaked a knee there.
Well, I hope she's okay.
She tweaked a knee a little bit. Well, that's what we don't need. Uncharacteristically, they've got really loose with the ball the last couple of minutes.
This will be, like I mentioned, I mean, you know, we got to hope we hang on here. There's 3 possessions. You got time right now, especially the way.
Yeah, let's keep it out of 12, Sam.
You know, we're trying to burn a little clock here, but they're down to 3 possessions and way that you know, Randall's is.
You know, Rogers is pressing so hard. We've got numbers if we'd attack it a little bit.
Well, I hope that she is okay down there. Randall's going to get a foul. That's the best time to score is when the clock stopped. 20.8 seconds.
Final quarter over 20, Cameron Bartholomew. Randall's at the line, shooting 2.
Randall's, like literally. Less than a minute and a half ago, she had 4 points. She's about to hit double digits and just that quickly. And there it is. So now a 41. It's a 2-possession game with 20.8 seconds. This thing is not over. Second one on the way, and this one is no good. And the rebound goes to Lopez. Boy, if they got the rebound there, that would have been something. Coach Froud has 3 timeouts. Not that he wants the clock to stop, but when you're in trouble like that, you might need to
sure.
take it.
Kind of bailed her out with a foul there.
Lopez at the line shooting for the Lady Tigers.
This is a 1-and-1, and
sometimes, you know, against that press, it's like they're playing kind of not to lose, you know.
And the free throw is no good. And now a chance to cut this down to a one-possession game. A three-pointer on the way. It is good.
Wow.
And it's 41-38.
We were already naming the star of the game, Lynn. This game's far from over now.
Timeout, Rogers.
And one of our best ball handlers, although we have several.
We took her back to the locker room.
Seven point 1 seconds, and I'm telling you,
man,
Randall's has just put the team on her back. You said she had 17 last night. She's got 14 tonight, and 10 of it literally in about a minute and a half.
Yeah, she definitely, you know, they made a couple of shots, and they started feeling good about themselves. You got to put a team away when you can. So, again, like you said a while ago, good learning. Coach Pratt will coach him up for this.
This is a big possession here, and because
we're gonna have to make some free throws.
Now, the one thing is, next time we will get two shots,
that
and
helps.
that's critical.
Well, before you get ahead of yourself, you just got to get the ball in bounds.
Yep. Gets it into Harton. They foul Harton. Only about a second and about a minute or a second and a half went off the clock. So 5.8. She needs to make at least one of these to make it a two-possession game, because they come down, a three-pointer ties this thing up.
One might do it.
Both will be fine. Harton with just 1 point tonight. Very uncharacteristic of her. And she, boy, wow, we got the roll. At first, I thought that was not going to go in. It does go in. And now 42-38.
No fouls now.
And now the second one on the way. It's good. 5-point lead. Now you can just kind of back off.
It's a senior step up to the line like that.
And
give it to him.
The basket's going to count. Final score. The Lady Tigers hang on. It was up by as many as 14 late in the game.
Win's a win.
A win is a win. That's 43-40 as the Lady Tigers defeat the Rogers Bounties, a 7A school. We lost to one 7A school earlier in the year. I believe they played Northside. And then
shame losing to Fort Smith Northside.
No, absolutely not. And our Everett Chevrolet player of the game, I believe, is going to go to Ashley Cox.
I agree with you.
Ashley Cox. 10 points.
10 big points.
But the thing is that she's really struggled with foul trouble the last few games. Tonight, no fouls for Ashley.
She played good defense, and again, 10 points for her. You'll take that every game.
You bet. You bet. Well, I'll tell you, it was a hard-fought battle. Randall, you want to go through the scoring real quick?
I can. Let's go with Prairie Grove girls first. Parker Lopez finished with 7. Taylor Doss with 3. Camry Bartholomew, 6 in the first half, 2 the second, end up with 8. Taylor Harton finished with 8. Maddie Harton finished with 2. 2 big free throws. Those were huge. Ashley again said she finished with 10. Sarah Stone finished with 1 point on the game.
Well, that's going to do it. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back for the boys' game. Again, the final score, the Lady Tigers 43, Lady Mounties 40. We'll be back for the boys' game. Give us about 8 minutes.
Everett Chevrolet, proud sponsors of Prairie Grove High School Athletics and also proud of their huge inventory, both new or used. You'll find what you're looking for at Everett Chevrolet. Are you looking for the most dependable, longest-lasting, full-size truck on the road?